Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Path of Exile. It's my build guide. It's my General's Cry, Lacerate, Cyclone, Juggernaut, Two-Handed Sword. So I remade the build, so more towards the Ultimate League, so with the system in the circles. So I got now Rampage, more tankiness, and a very low budget. So I worked around, so most of the time I just post the video with like my end gear, but now I went with the lowest currency gear that I can have to get tier 60 maps. You guys will see after this a tier 50 map, very juiced. So you can work of course higher. I'm going to work now higher because I got the currency already. But you guys can see it here. So all the price of the gear that I use in the video is here. So my sword is 70C, helmet 20C, amulet 20C, the chest 45C. My rings are the most expensive. So the cluster jewels are here too. So what you see now in the build, and I'm going to show you guys right away the gameplay, a tier 50 map, is like in total 962 Geos and 6.4 Exalted. That's today with a ratio of 1 Exalt is 1 Geos. I just checked it on the Po trade. So it's very low budget for people that now say to me, yeah, 6.4 Exalted is a lot. You need to play another game. If you want to do tier 60 maps and you will want to go with 20C, it's not going to work. So it's very budget friendly. You can do it. Of course, it's slower because you're missing the DPS. I'm still using like a 300 DPS sword and all that stuff. But you can do it because you're very tanky. So enjoy the map, the tier 50 map, and then I'm coming back with the next part of the video.
I cannot do this yet. My mana is gone.
Now is your chance to slay them amongst the flames. Conspires with the flames. flames beget more flames. Night's madness drains away all hope.
I cannot do this yet. Vengeance is cold indeed. You will fall to ruin. You have redeemed yourself.
In my sights, exile. Off you go, little beast. Away! This one is captured. I now will take it.
I cannot do this yet.
On this capture with pride, exile. You hunt well. Do not worry, little beast. We are friends now. Aina will take it.
what you cannot see. No! Give no quarter!
Twice as hard!
Ghost Flame!
Blasting coils.
Curses!
Okay, guys, the next part, we are now in the game, and what I'm going to show you guys is the setup of the gear. So, how does this build work? So, it's a Juggernaut. He got a lot of tankiness, 7 endurance charges. It got these two, so for the guys that don't understand, so Transcendence, it's called. So, what do you need to do to trigger this? You need to buy a Militant Fate, Timeless Jewel. With the High Templar Maxarius. And then this will, it's Unwavering Stance normally, this will become Transcendence. What is Transcendence? It's going to make you almost immune for elemental damage. So the armor applies to fire, cold and lightning damage taken from hits instead of physical damage. And then you get the minus 5% to all maximum elemental resistance. So what does that mean? That the armor is going to mitigate the elemental damage. So it works like this. So you guys can now see I got 53 fire resistance. It will go to 70 to maximum because my endurance charges will boost it with 28% too. So if you got 70% fire resistance, so you get 10,000 elemental damage in from fire. So 70% is mitigated right away. Then you got like 3,000 that is still coming through. So let's say that's 30% still. And then the amount of reduction that you got from your armor is applied on those 30%. For me, that's 60% of 30%. That's 18% of 30%. So if you put 80% with 70%, you guys got 88% reduction against that hit. So from the 10,000, you will mitigate 8,800 damage. And you only get 1,200 damage through. So therefore, it is very good. The biggest problem that you got, if you use it, you still need to mitigate your physical damage. Because armor is not anymore doing the physical damage. So therefore I did two solutions. So first of all, I got 7 endurance charges. So that's in total 28% that I got. And then I got this chest, the Crancenian's Carapace Golden Plate. So what it's going to do, you got the crab aspect of the crab. So you guys can see it here. And if you put it up, you will get 15 crab aspects, and every aspect got 2% physical mitigation. So at the end, you got 30%. I got now 34, because I think somewhere I got another. No, it's from the endurance charge that I got all the time. But there is one big problem. If you lose all the barriers, if you get a physical damage hit. But it goes really quick. So if you do now the calculations, so I got 34. No, I got 30 with the crab. I got 28 I got with my endurance charges. So that's in total already 58. And then I got the Phantians too. So this Phantian I'm always using. So if you got one boss, so one enemy near, you got 60% more. That's already 64 that I got. And or you can use this too for mapping. So at the end I got 65%. But that's not all. Because I got this too on my helmet. So 10% of physical damage is taking as fire damage. So because I got a lot of mitigation against fire, 88%. So 10% of that number is mitigated again. So at the end, I will be around 60 to 65% against physical damage. So it's a little bit of workaround, but it works really well. So that's that's why you are not going to take a lot of damage of elemental damage. And that's why you are going to not take a lot of damage or physical damage. So that's one of the very big physical... one of the very big defensive things that I use in the build. So I wanted to explain that a little bit to you guys. Then another thing, I'm using Rampage. So, and these are very good gloves. Do you guys still remember what I said, physical damage? So Rampage is something very cool. So it's going with stages, and every stage, so you need to keep killing enemies, and every stage you get something cool that kills enemies. It's very good for Ultimatum, therefore I put it in the build. But why it's so good, the Null and Void Legion gloves? Because it removes elemental ailment on Rampage. It's not, if you get it the first time, every stage it will reset. I thought at the start, damn, it's only one time. No, I think Rampage got like 10, 12 stages or something. So every stage is going to reset the elemental ailments too. And the other thing is very good too. Gain immunity to physical damage for 1.5 seconds. So if you go to an ultimatum circle, you already saw it, of course, in the video of the gameplay. But you always trigger it. Therefore, it's so good. And therefore, I wanted it in the build. So that are the mechanics. And then for the other part, of course, I'm a juggernaut. And what is a juggernaut? It's very tanky. So I got this. So you cannot get stunned. You will keep always a certain speed. It's very good. So stun, you never can ignore that in this game. Because you die. And if you cyclone around, you get stunned, you're dead. That's how it is. Then I'm using Unbreakable too. Unbreakable is very good. Double the armor. So armor is now against elemental schools. Therefore it's very good. Then this one is just going to generate the whole time endurance charges. But you will never lose your endurance charges. So you always keep it up because you don't consume them. And then this one is unyielding. So why is this so good? Increased area of effect. A bigger cone on the cyclone. And increase damage per endurance charge. Another thing that a lot of people always ask me. How do you get rage with this cluster jewel? So blood scent. Blood scent is going to build up the rage. That's very, very important. So I think I said everything. Now I'm going to talk a little bit how the build works. So what do you do? I got a 6-link Cyclone and at the moment a 5-link on General Cry. So how does it work? So the Cyclone is very simple. So you just get the Cyclone. You guys can see every supported gem, Impale of course, Fortify, Brutality, Melee Physical Damage and Infused Channeling. So that's going to do some damage. And with doing damage, you will get on trash, you will get bodies on the ground. And General's Cry is going to consume the bodies and is going to make warriors. And those warriors, they are going to do the spell Lacerate. Because it's connected with General Cry. I got here Concentrated Effects, Pulverize and Brutality. If you got a 6-link, you need to get melee physical damage. So that's really cool, because it's like Lacerate is doing almost the same amount of damage as Cyclone. So you're doing 2 times damage, because Cyclone is not so good for a single target. But Lacerate is very good for single target. And I'm using it in Blood Stance. So therefore it's very good. So that's how it works. How does it work on bosses? Because on bosses, most of the time, you don't have bodies on the ground. I use Desecrate with Cast when damage taken. Sometimes it's hard, because if you fight the totem and the totem is not hitting you, you cannot put the desecrated ground on the ground and you don't can use your General Cry. So therefore, the Cast when damage taken is very low. People always ask me this too. So why is Cast when damage taken so low? Because I want to have as soon as possible Desecrate on the ground. So a central warship is here too. I put it on F1 and F2 for the guys that don't understand how you need to do more than this. You just push control. Then you put a hotkey on your warships. So F1 or F2. You don't see it. You just push F1. Here you go. And you will see that here is the central warship. I got a lot of questions about that too. People always ask me that. So therefore I'm saying it. Then you got here on the gloves, you got the Enlighten level 3, so I keep it low. Level 4 is of course a lot better. Then Blood and Scent, Dread Banner, Pride of course, I still need to level it out. Then on the boots, you got increased duration, you got faster attacks, you got Leap Slam, and you got Molten Shell. So if you click Molten Shell, you put always on your run button. So you just run around, and if it procs, it procs. So Berserk is here too. Where do I have Berserk? I think here too, yeah, at the helmet. So if you got 5 rage, you can use Berserk. Berserk is very good for DPS, but it's very good for less damage taken, almost 90%, so it mitigates damage too. So that's a little bit how the build works. So you just go around, you use your general cry, it's instant. So it's here on instant. And if you come on a boss, you get hit, you got desecrated ground on the ground, you can use your general cry. So another thing, the flasks. No, I'm going to say one thing more. Get a Stygian Vice and get the Geminid that you get onslaught on a kill. So you get it on the maps too. Very important, try to get boots with armor, because armor is boosting the mitigation against elemental damage. So it's a little bit strange thinking, but that's how you need to do it. The flasks are very straight on, it's only 20C, you guys saw it. So Forbidden Taste is very good. Why it's good? You got phasing, very good in the ultimate in circle. Dodge attacks, dodge spells. And it recovers 87 of life on use. So it's instant, you're back full. You will take a little bit later 8% of maximum life taken as Chaos damage, but that's not really a big problem, because Chaos resistance is very, very high. This is very good too, Blood of the Kyrie. Be sure that you make it 20 quality. Of course, Lion's Roar is very important. This is very important too. And this is very good too. It's so good for defensive, and you can use it on the Juggernaut, because we cannot get petrified. If we always keep moving, so this is going to do so much immunity to damage if you're in the circle. You cannot cast it that long. I got now 13% quality. I think I can go to 1.5, 1.6 seconds that I can use it, but you guys can see it in the video, you just saw it. I always go around and I just push always, if they are on cooldown, those three. So when I just go around the whole time and just push them the whole time, and you get almost immune to damage on that moment. So that's a little bit playstyle that you need to do. For the other part, get vulnerability here on the ring. Get channel skills have minus total cost. So at the moment my Cyclone is 4 mana. That's enough. I'm not going to do strange things with the gear, because otherwise it's going to get too expensive. So therefore I just keep it very low. So you guys, if you want to get, of course, an enchant, what is good? Attack speed for Cyclone is good. Pride is, reservation of Pride is minus 15% is good too. But at the end, it does not matter that much, because this works. You cannot get Flesh and Stone in the build. Or you need to go with Pride, less reservation on the helmet, less reservation on the amulet, and you need to get Enlighten 4. Then I think you can just get it in. But at the moment I'm not using it. So I'm using Bloodstance. Just Bloodstance in Bloodstance. I'm using Crab Aspect. I'm using Dread Banner. And I'm using Pride. That are the auras that I'm using at the moment. So that's it a little bit, guys. So I cannot say more. It's not that easy to understand. But all the mechanics I just explained, I'm going to show you guys really quick the Phantoms that you need to use, then it's the Path of Building, and then I'm done. So that was it for a little bit the mechanic, the gear and all that stuff, a little bit side information. Okay guys, to end the video, I'm now in Path of Building, and you guys can see I got the bandits are 2 passive points. Then you need to take the Phantoms. The Phantoms are very important. Be sure that you level them out, that you got all the slots in them. So you need to take the soul of Solaris. That's very important. And you need to take soul of Shakari. Why Shakari? It's going to make you almost immune against poison. Because poison keeps stacking. So we are going to talk now about the damage. So at the moment damage is very low. How high can you go with the damage? I think 10 to 14, 15 million at the end bill. If you go to the very high end gear. Where can you see the very high end gear? That's on the website because I already got a post on it. So you guys can check there the end gear. I'm not going to put it here. Because it's not that easy. Because I know if I put here a sword in, it's 40 exalted. And somebody doesn't know it's for the end gear. He's going to think he's going to need it. So I don't put other stuff than what I use in the video in Path of Building. So the DPS at the moment is 1 million. That's for the Cyclone. And for the General Cry, it's 381,000. So that's around 1.6 million DPS that I'm doing. It's not a lot, but it's only for 6 exalted, so you can do everything with it. You can scale it a lot higher if you want, but that's how it is at the moment. So you guys can see too, so I got physical reduction 58. It's a little bit higher because they are not counting the Phantom. I already said it in the video. So everything is kept now. Chaos resistance is high too, 45. So it's really decent. My armor is 32,000, so you guys saw me doing it on 15,000, so it's even higher, the elemental mitigation. So it's very, very decent. I cannot say more about this build, so you guys can see it here. I will post it under the video too. I will post it on the website too. You guys can see there the end gear. So what can you do if you want to get higher? Of course, get an exquisite weapon, a sword, because now it's only 379,000. Ah, before I forgot. Okay, for the enchant on the amulet, I did not talk about it. So there are a couple enchants that are very good. So this is very good. Fatal Blade is very good. Going to boost your DPS with a lot. But I would go for this one, because at some point, at the moment, the sword is still generating frenzy charges. So you guys can see here, gain a frenzy charge on a critical strike. So if you replace it, you're not going to get frenzy charges anymore. And it's not that bad. You can put Blood Rage in cast when damage taken, but the desecrated ground is then gone. On map bosses, it's not really a problem. But if you go for Shaper or other bosses, it's going to be a problem. But if you want to get the Frenzy Charges, I would use this. Charging Offensive as an enchant on the amulet. Chance to gain a Frenzy Charge when hit while channeling. So take this one or this one. Where is it? Fatal Blades. So I didn't talk about it. And that's it a little bit, guys. I cannot say more anymore. Yeah, Exquisite Blade, 600-700 DPS is the next upgrade. You can use the Abyssis too in this build, but I didn't do it. Otherwise, people are starting to whine that they die too much. And they think it's the Abyssis, so I didn't do it. But for the guys that are familiar with playing on high tier maps, you can use it. I'm going to use it. It's going to boost my DPS with a couple of million more. The other upgrades, you can get a Bottle of Fate too, a Diamond Flask of course, if you are feeling comfortable with the DPS. And that's it a little bit, guys, so thanks for watching, have fun, bye bye.